Now I'll discuss inversions of double slider crank mechanism. In double slider crank mechanism, two turning pairs and two sliding pairs, and it is also a four bar mechanism. And some of the inversions of double slider crank mechanisms are elliptical trammel, Scotch yoke mechanism, whole damped coupling. Now we will discuss one by one. Elliptical trammel. And what is this elliptical trammel? The name itself indicates that this elliptical trammel is used to draw an ellipse. Here, in the elliptical trammel, it is having a fixed frame, and in this fixed frame there are slots, slotted fixed frame. This one is a slotted fixed frame, and these two are the blocks sliding inside that fixed slotted fixed frame, and this C and D are the blocks sliding inside the fixed frame. And here this B and A, there is a sliding pair between A and B, and here also between C and A there is a sliding pair. And between this with reference to this BC, it is a turning pair. Okay, two sliding pairs and two turning pairs. Here it is the instrument for drawing the ellipse. It is used for drawing an ellipse. Okay, the slotted frame is fixed. Here it is a slotted frame A. It is fixed, and any point such as C, yes, here we will consider the tracing point S on this link here, and at the midpoint of AB we'll trace an ellipse as the slide blocks A. Here the slide blocks are B and C along the respective slots. They are moving along the respective slots. Here this point S will trace an ellipse. This is the tracing point. Here we will consider this, how we will prove that how it draw an ellipse, or it will trace an ellipse. For that we are using this small trigonometric, we are using a trigonometric functions, relations we are using, that cos theta and sin theta. Here cos theta is equal to x divided by this C, S, this, and sin theta is equal to y divided by this B, S, this B and S. Y is equal to B, S, and here x is equal to cos theta C, S, and we know we will substitute C, S is equal to A. Only for simplification we are substituting this C, S is equal to A, and here it is B, S is equal to B. And squaring and adding these two, this x is equal to cos theta cs and y is equal to sin theta bs, and in place of bs we are substituting this b, and in place of cs we are substituting this a, and squaring and adding we will get sin square theta plus cos square theta. The in place of sin square theta plus cos square theta we will substitute, it is equal to 1. And in if we squaring and adding these two equations, x is equal to cos theta a and y is equal to sin theta b, we'll get x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. This is an equation of ellipse. This x square by a square and y square by b square is equal to sin square theta plus cos square theta. That sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Here, which is the, and if it is exactly at the center and the path traced by that point S is an ellipse having A and B, or the here the semi major and semi minor axis of the ellipse, and if the tracing point is placed at the midpoint of this, okay, if the tracing point is placed at the midpoint of this BC, then A and B are equal. Okay, then we will we will get an expression x square plus y square is equal to a square, that which is the equation of a circle. Okay, that x square plus y square is equal to a square, that is the equation of the circle, because here the semi major axis and the minor axis are equal, it is exactly at the center. Okay, this elliptical trammel is used to draw an ellipse. Then Scotch yoke mechanism, this is also one of the inversion of a double slider crank chain or a mechanism. This is the Scotch yoke mechanism. Here it converts rotary motion into a reciprocating motion. That is the Scotch yoke mechanism. Here in this Scotch yoke mechanism, also two sliding pairs and the two turning pairs, that we have already discussed in the double slider crank mechanism, two turning pairs and the two sliding pairs. And here that one of the link is fixed here, this link, link 1 is fixed here, it is shown in the figure, it is link 1 is fixed, and the block, this one is the block or the link, it is in the form of a block, the link is in the form of a block. And here this is the crank, this one is the crank, it converts rotary motion into a reciprocating motion. And one more inversion of the double slider crank mechanism is the Oldham's coupling. And this Oldham's coupling, we know that we are using this Oldham's coupling to connect or to transmit the power from one shaft to the other. And these shafts are parallel to each other, but they are not collinear. It is a distance, offset distance here. Okay, this is the end view or the side view of this. Okay, here the axes are not collinear, but they are parallel. And in that Oldham's coupling, the frame and the other block will turn through the same angular displacement. And here also there are two sliding pairs. This coupling is used to connect the shafts which are parallel but not collinear. And here this middle one, this link 3, okay, this is link 1, 2, 3, 4, and that this link 3 is having a two tangents, rectangular tangents on both sides, and they are perpendicular to each other. And these 2 and 4, links 2 and 4 having a rectangular slots in that. And this link 3, it is sliding. Okay, this link 3 is sliding and these two are rotating. Okay, this is they having a sliding pair or the sliding motion. Okay, the sliding inside the slots which are provided in link 2 and link 4. And the link 1 is fixed. Okay, now we will see that how that it will work. Okay, see here, this is the animation of Oldham's coupling. This is the middle one. It is having a two tangents perpendicular to each other on both sides of the link. And this this link and this link are having a slots. Okay, only on one side. And these at the middle one, that link is having two tangents perpendicular to each other. Okay, this is the animation of the Oldham's coupling. And this one is the animation of the elliptical trammel, which we have discussed. And it will trace a path, an ellipse. Please observe this. It will trace a path. And if it is exactly at the center, the tracing point in that link, it will trace a circle. Okay. And this is the Scotch yoke mechanism. Here, this converts rotary motion into a reciprocating motion. Okay, earlier we have discussed that in a single slider crank mechanism, it converts a reciprocating motion of a piston into a rotary motion. But here it converts rotary motion into a reciprocating motion. Okay, these are some of the inversions of double slider crank mechanism. Next, Grashof's law and its inversions. What is the condition for Grashof's law, or the statement for the Grashof's law? And this Grashof's law states that for a four-bar mechanism, the sum of the lengths of the largest and the shortest links should be less than or equal to the sum of the lengths of the other two links. Here, okay, it is L plus S is less than or equal to A plus B. Here, it is a four-bar mechanism. This is a four-bar mechanism. This is the shortest link and this is the longest link. And these two are the other two links. Okay, this it is A plus B or P plus Q. You can take any name, but it is other two links. These two are the other two links. L plus S is less than or equal to A plus B. And this is the larger length of this, sum of the lengths of shortest and the longest link lengths is less than or equal to sum of the lengths of other two links. Okay. This is called the Grashof's law. And here, if it satisfies the Grashof's law or the condition, it is possible to have three inversions. If it satisfies this condition, L plus S is less than or equal to A plus B, it is possible to have three inversions. They are crank rocker mechanism, double crank mechanism, and double rocker mechanism. Okay, in the first, we will discuss one by one this crank rocker mechanism. Okay, in this crank rocker mechanism, the link adjacent to the shortest link is fixed. Okay, this is the link. This one is the link adjacent to the shortest link. Here, this is the shortest link. This is the link adjacent to the shortest link is fixed. We will obtain this crank rocker mechanism. This is the crank rocker mechanism. One link completely rotates and the other one will oscillate. That we call it as crank rocker. Okay. One link completely rotates and the other will oscillate. Here also, in the example, in this example, the link adjacent to this shortest link is fixed. Here, this is the link adjacent to this shortest link is fixed. We will obtain crank rocker mechanism. Okay, this link will completely rotate and this will oscillate. Okay, this is called the crank rocker mechanism. If it satisfies the in a four bar mechanism, if it satisfies the Grashof's law, it is possible to have three inversions: crank rocker mechanism, double crank mechanism, double rocker mechanism. Okay, next is, this is the here double crank mechanism. This one is the double crank mechanism. Two links will completely rotate. Here, see here, this circle indicates it will completely rotate. It will trace a path of circle, okay, that is moving in this direction. And here the shortest link is fixed. In a double crank mechanism, shortest link is fixed. This is the shortest link. Here the shortest link is fixed. It is possible to have this double crank mechanism. And the next one is the double rocker mechanism. Okay, in this condition, the link opposite to the shortest link is fixed. The link opposite to the shortest link is fixed. It is possible to have double rocker mechanism. This one is the double rocker mechanism. These are the some of the inversions of Grashof's chain or a four bar mechanism, which we have already discussed earlier. And now we will see the animation of this. This is the crank rocker mechanism. Okay, this link will completely rotate and this will oscillate. Okay, here the link which is adjacent to the shortest link is fixed. This is the link adjacent to this shortest link. This will link will completely rotate and this will oscillate. This is called the crank rocker mechanism. And here double crank mechanism. Here this is a double crank mechanism and the parallelogram mechanism. Here opposite links are parallel to each other and they are equal, parallel to each other and they are equal. They will trace a path, two circles. That indicates that it is a double crank mechanism, and which we have already seen when we were discussing the inversions of the four bar chain, that coupled wheel of a locomotive, that there we are using the similar type of mechanism. Okay, this is a double crank mechanism, and this one is the double rocker mechanism. Okay, here no link will completely rotate, only they will oscillate. Okay, here this will oscillate, this link. Okay, this indicates that it is a double rocker mechanism. Okay, this is the condition for double rocker mechanism. Here in the double rocker mechanism, the link opposite to the shortest link is fixed. Okay, here this one, this is a double rocker mechanism. These are the animations of the different inversions of the Grashof's chain. Now we will discuss numerical examples on Grashof's chain based on the the link lengths. Okay, here we have to identify whether it is a crank rocker mechanism or a double rocker mechanism, whether it satisfies the Grashof's chain or not, or the Grashof's statement or not. We know that in the Grashof's statement, S plus L is less than or equal to A plus B. Then only it is possible to have three inversions. Okay, we will consider this example here, the first one. Here, the length of the links are given here. This is the, let me take, this is 5 centimeter, 6, 9 centimeter and 7. Okay, if we substitute that in the Grashof's equation, S plus L is less than or equal to A plus B. Here, S is 5, L is 9 and other two links are 6 and 7 centimeters. Okay, now if we substitute that in this S plus L, S is 5 plus 9 and it is 7 plus 6. 9 plus 5, 14 and the 7 plus 6, 13. Okay, now it does not satisfy the Grashof's condition. S plus L is less than or equal to A plus B. Then it is not possible to have the three inversions, and it is possible to have only one inversion, that is the double rocker mechanism. Okay, we will identify which type of mechanism it is. Okay, if it does not satisfy the Grashof's law, it is not possible to have the three inversions. Okay, here it is. Here in the second example, the length of the shortest link is 4 and the longest link is 9. Okay, that is S is 4 plus 9. Here A plus B, 7 plus 7. Okay, here 9 plus 4, 13. 7 plus 7, 14. Here S plus L is less than A plus B. It satisfies the Grashof's condition. S plus L is less than or equal to A plus B. Or sum of the lengths of the shortest and the longest length links must be less than or equal to the sum of the lengths of other two links. Okay, here it satisfies the Grashof's condition. Then one more thing, here the shortest link is fixed. If the shortest link is fixed, we will call that as a double crank mechanism, which we have seen here. If the shortest link is fixed, we call that as a double crank mechanism, or it is also called as a drag link mechanism. Okay, the double crank mechanism. Next, I'll discuss quick return motion mechanisms. And what are these quick return motion mechanisms? Quick return motion mechanisms are used to perform repetitive operations. And here, repetitive operations means that it is continuously moving, to and fro, continuously moving from to and fro. And during forward stroke, it will take more time than the return stroke. Okay, here in a machine tools, for example, in shaping machine, during the forward stroke, it will perform some work, and during the return stroke, it will come back to its original position just to repeat the operation. Okay, and during return stroke, it is moving very fast to save the idle time. okay, to reduce the idle time of the machine tool. It will move very fast during return. It will move very fast. Okay, that we call it as quick return motion. Okay, that is used to perform the repetitive operations, and during the forward stroke it will take more time than return stroke. And the ratio of time for working stroke. Working stroke means when it is during the forward stroke, it will remove the material from the workpiece. That we call it as a working stroke. To the time for the return stroke is known as the time ratio. Okay, this is very important here. The ratio of the time working stroke to the time for the return stroke is known as the time ratio. And here some of the quick return motion, the most commonly used quick return motion mechanisms are drag link mechanism, Whitworth mechanism, crank and slotted lever mechanism. Here this is the inversion just now we have discussed. That is the inversion of the Grashof's chain or a four bar mechanism. In this inversion, the shortest link is fixed. Okay, here it is a shortest link is fixed. And it is also an example for the double crank mechanism. Okay, this Whitworth drag link mechanism is an example for the double crank mechanism. Then we will move on to the Whitworth quick return motion mechanism. Here this is the Whitworth quick return motion mechanism. Here this link is fixed. This link is fixed and it is used in slotting machine or shaping machine. Again, in all these quick return mechanisms are used in shaping machine or slotting machine to reduce the idle time. Okay, because during the forward stroke it will remove the material or it will do some work, and during the return stroke just it will come back to its original position to repeat the operation. That's what we are using these quick return. Okay, that is okay, in almost all these quick return mechanisms we are using the same concept. It is used on slotting or shaping machines. Here the one crank that is rotates at uniform speed, and that block P, here there is a block P, it is slides inside this slotted link. Okay, this is the slotted link, and this block P is sliding inside this slotted link. And this link revolve, and it is having a variable speed, and it is connected to the RAM. Okay, the RAM, this is the RAM which is connected to the cutting tool. Okay, that it is attached to the cutting tool. Okay, the RAM or okay, this we are using that name RAM or, which is attached to that cutting tool, is connected to this link, and the arm reciprocates along the line of stroke. Okay, this is the stroke we will call the movie. This RAM will reciprocates. Okay, this is the RAM which it will reciprocates, and here the movement of the arm from left to the right. Okay, this is the movement of the arm from left to the right be the cutting stroke, and this quick return motion mechanism is used to reduce the idle time of the machine. Okay, it is moving this. Okay, in almost all the quick return motion mechanism we are using the same concept. It is used to reduce the idle time of the machine tool or the machine. Then this is the crank and slotted lever mechanism. Okay, this is the animation of this Whitworth quick return motion mechanism. please observe here, during forward stroke it is moving slowly and during return stroke it will move very fast. Please observe this to reduce the idle time of the machine. Okay, here also in crank and slotted lever mechanism, the same concept which we are using. During the forward stroke it will take more time and during the return stroke it is taking less time. Okay, here that this is also the inversion of the single slider crank mechanism which we have discussed already. This one here, this is the crank and it is a that this is the crank, this link 2 is a crank and this here this is a cutting tool and this is a slotted link and this block is moving inside this slotted link. And this oscillation of this link will transfer to the this arm, okay, which is connected to the cutting tool. This oscillating motion of this will transfer to this link or the lever which is connected to the cutting tool. And here the time ratio, okay, during forward stroke it will take more time and during return stroke it is taking less time. And this mechanism is also used in shaping machine, slotting machine, and also it is used in rotary engine. Okay, that please observe here. Here also during forward stroke it is moving slowly or it will take more time and during return stroke it is moving fast and it saves the idle time of the machine.